I imagine my CD like a door that a listener can walk through. Each song is like a different hinge on which the door swings. My CD current is just that. It's a current of thoughts and drum beats and guitar strums and melodies and vocals, all swirling together in an attempt to capture the towering highs and plummeting lows of life. These songs were found strapped on the inside of my heart and running across the backs of my eyelids, standing on the tip of my tongue, just waiting to share about my great God and how He's revealing Himself to me and what He's done for me and what He promises to continue to do. There are themes that overlap from song to song on my CD, like the outro to the song Hope says, "We will run, we will laugh, we will dance, we will shout when you're back for us, you'll come back for us." You can find the same thoughts of living a life of running and dancing and shouting and laughing in my song We Should Run. And then you can find my thoughts about a Savior coming back for His people on my song You're Coming. Other themes might be more subtle, like the relationship between Galaxy Former and the Damaged. The chorus on the Damaged says, "I don't want to be the one who's broken. I don't want to be the one who falls apart. I don't want to be the Damaged." I wrote this song after seeing a picture of a woman from a third world country who had a badly deformed arm. The paragraphs below the picture said that the woman had broken her arm and the deformity was a result of her not having access to a doctor or someone who could properly reset the arm. It grew back together incorrectly and misshapen, making the arm nearly unusable because of this. At this point in my life, I had been hit by tragedy after tragedy and found myself wondering if I could possibly ever recover. Would I end up like this woman? Or like many of those who walk around who are emotionally damaged? Would I end up like one of the people who lives like there are broken bits of themselves that are never really reset properly, leaving them emotionally or spiritually limping? This is where Galaxy Former comes in. Who would be the one to fix my broken life? The creator of this life, a Galaxy Former, the one who makes all things right. One of my favorite songs on this record. I found myself feeling really frustrated about how the world, through TV and magazines and the internet, or even my friends sometimes, tries to tear marriages apart. I'm a runner, and I began to think about a marathon that I ran recently and how hard it was for me to train for it and to run it. And although I live in San Diego, California, I flew to Fort Worth, Texas to run this marathon because that's where all my family is. And I needed to have as many people as possible lining the race to cheer me on. I knew that I would need the support, and boy, did I. They showed up in droves. They held up signs, chanting my name and shouting, "You can do it! We're so proud of you! Don't give up! It's not much further! And it's so worth it!" I imagine taking the same scenario, and how different the shouting and the signs would sound and look if they were what the world is telling us about marriage. It would sound like this. It would say, "Give up. Quit. It's too hard. You're tired and you deserve to be able to be done. It's not worth it." I wrote the song Current as the biggest sign that I could hold up for anyone who is married to say, "Don't give up. I believe in you. It is worth it." I found myself thinking, "Sarah, what do you want someone to walk away with who listens to your CD? When it all gets boiled down, what is the hum that's vibrating through each song?" I think the hum is found most clearly in the last song, Joy Comes In. It's written from Psalm 30, verses 5 and 11 and 12. It says, "Weeping may last for a night, but joy comes in the morning. And you have turned from me my mourning into dancing, and have put off my sackcloth and clothed me with gladness. To the end, that my glory may sing praise to you and not be silent. O Lord my God, I will give thanks to you forever. This is the place that I want to be. These are the final words that I want to stick anyone who hears my songs or music. That despite the circumstances that invaded my life, I will rejoice in the Lord, singing his praise will not be silent. The definition of hallelujah is a shout of joy or praise or gratitude. And joy comes in as my hallelujah.